I love democracy. I love the Republic.
The main thing is to protect these characters, make sure that they still continue to live in the way that you created them, and that the universe of Star Wars continues to grow.
It's Stephanie. Welcome back to the Cantina. Wanted to talk a little bit about the retirement of James Earl Jones. Apparently, Mr. Jones is retiring from doing the voice of Darth Vader. Now, from what it looks like, Lucasfilm and Disney are going to be able to use his voice. And as of right now, they can pretty much make any voice they want. Okay, so with the technology, they've got some Eastern European company working with them too. So it's kind of cool that they can do that, but it's sad. The two people who created Darth Vader, David Prowse, is gone, passed away a while ago now. And now James Earl Jones, who's in his 90s, is no longer going to be doing it. The voice, every bit as much as the costume, was iconic. And it, you know, I'm not going to say it hurt Star Wars. Everybody has to have a chance to relax in their lives. And voice work, I'm not going to say it's like, you know, raising a herd of 100 bison or, you know, the middle of July in a hayfield. But it's you know, for someone of a certain age, it probably is hard. So I am proud of him. God bless him. I'm not going to freak out like I saw Black Pill doing today on Twitter. I respect the fact that the man worked really, really, really hard and gave us this iconic character, okay? Because David Prowse embodied the character, and when he walked, he swaggered. He was a big man, okay? He was, what, 6'5", 6'6"? So he towered over everybody. And when he walked, he had a certain swagger, you know, the David Prowse swagger, in my opinion, when you saw him in the Vader costume, was every bit as important, I think, and iconic as the John Wayne swagger, okay? And those just can't be repeated. I mean, you know, Hayden Christensen isn't that big. He's like, what, 6 feet tall? You know, maybe the guys that actually have to wear the armor are as big, but they, you know, I agree with Star Wars theory that there's something missing when you don't see that moving, that panther-like move with that big man swagger, that barrel chest, you know? And of course, then there's the voice. And, you know, you hear that deep baritone that resonates, and it's like, it's scary. Coming from that big man, it's scary. Okay. Anyway, I want to talk a little bit more. So that's going on. And there's something else I wanted to say too about Star Wars, and I can't. Tony Gilroy. So Tony Gilroy goes on, and he encouraged his the people working on Andor to get rid of their affection for Star Wars to make Andor. I'm like, this is the problem. You, well, all right, and when I get shit from people, this is when I get mad, okay? This is when it's like, fuck you. If you want to blow him, blow him, okay? But I'm sorry, I'm a Star Wars fan. I'm not going to invest an hour or 45 minutes every Wednesday into a show that says Star Wars Andor, and there's no Star Wars in it, okay? It's not Andor bringing people to see it. It's Star Wars, okay? You know, the first three episodes were slow, even the third one, okay? The only part that was interesting is when they were stuck in that warehouse and those hinges and wheelies started coming down, swinging at them and you know, getting very close to turning, you know, Luthen into Luthen paste and Andor into a bloody redwood spot in cement. Okay. It was very interesting to me. I mean, the story is good, but it should have started out in episode 3. Okay. The cliches, all of it. And it's like, just forget how much you love Star Wars and let's just write this. And of course, I'm getting shit for going, when Star Wars happens, call me, by the fucking shills on Instagram right now. Trust me, they're dead. I'm going to crush them like bugs. I'm sick of it. I can't, I cannot. Why the fuck can't someone have an opinion to saying, I gave it a 2.5. It's mediocre. There's no Star Wars in it. Be proud that you made a Star Wars show without Star Wars. But don't expect me to kiss your ass. Okay, period, all right? I don't give a shit about Andor. I fucking don't care, okay? You know, and all this faux compassion. What? Anyway, I don't care. There's no one except for this Luthen character that I like in this show. Okay, I don't care about the natives and the kids and, you know, Marva, who looks like she stinks. I don't care. I don't fucking care. Okay, anyway, I think not having Star Wars in a Star Wars show is going to hurt it. Okay, you know, people who have seen it are like, we like it, but... you know, they can't look. Lucasfilm will never find a happy medium because they fucked up the sequel trilogy. And this is why people are pissed off. Then they want to go off in a completely different direction and not fix what they broke. And that's the problem. You've got people who don't love Star Wars. Tony Gilroy is very proud of not being a fan. I'm a fan now. Fuck you. Fuck you. Fuck you. Fuck you. Okay. The only reason why Rogue One worked, Tarkin, Vader, Leia, that's it. The thing that saved Rogue One was Vader throwing Krennic around like a rag doll. And then at the end, the scene in the hallway where Vader's fucking Vader. Okay. That's Star Wars. Tarkin basically taking over the Death Star in a fucking move like you can't believe politically is Star Wars, okay? Leia at the end bringing the alliance in with Scarif, that's it. That's Star Wars. Everything else was, I didn't care about Saw Gerrera. I didn't care about Cassian Andor. Jyn Erso, I cared about her dad. All right, but she's just another generic brunette British bitch that Kathy Kennedy just had to have in her show to feel good about herself. That's it, okay. And it's still better than anything they made. All right, but still, it had Star Wars in it, okay. There you go, it had Star Wars in it. Okay, so, and this is another thing, big news. So, I decided after having a few of my subscribers here ask me what about building my channel and building my office and my studio so I could actually have people on and do, you know, all of that stuff. Now, I'm going to tell you something. This is a fundraiser. This does not have anything to do with super chats or monetizing my channel. I don't fucking want to. Okay? I don't want to fucking want to because I want to be able to do what I want. All right? And if I do that, I'd have to literally take almost every video I have off. And I wouldn't be able to use the content I want. Okay? I'm not gonna bend to their fucking will. Okay. So I'm going to put in the description, the PayPal link to the fundraiser. It only goes on till, the 24th of October. All right. And it's not for a lot of money. I don't need a lot, but just enough to get the studio going and odds and ends I need to make it look nice in there. Okay. Now, I've got all the artwork. I've got artwork coming out of my ears. But I think I probably need a regular generic computer, camera, microphone, earphones, and probably some other things. And I don't know. I'd have to ask somebody. But this is just a quick thing. We'll see how it works. And this is the only one I'm ever going to do. Unless... the dog or the horse need an operation. Okay. So anyway, wanted to put this out there. This is Steph signing out. I'll see you around the galaxy.